Jay Shrek, Myths, Legends, and Lies. Me and James are on the trail of the Lost Dutchman. And what we're doing is we're taking the loop around the superstitions. So the first day trip, we got over to the first trailhead. And then now the second day, what we're doing is we're going even farther, and we're going to an area that they call the Miniature Grand Canyon. And you want to go to someplace that's absolutely spectacular, this is it. So I'm going to show you a car that's coming down this hill. Now, the significance of the car coming down the hill is that we had a very special situation happen down here at one time where this was the location of the last stagecoach robbery and the first car robbery in the state of Arizona. And they came down this very hill, and we're going to show you this car. So the car would come down this very road right here, crossing that bridge. Today I'm in the exact cave that Hacksaw Tom used to perform the last wagon train that was robbed in the state of Arizona, and the first car that was robbed in the state of Arizona. At the same exact point, the same exact place, we're at a place on the outskirts of the Superstition Mountains called Fish Creek. And it's a gorgeous place. And I'm in the very cave that Hacksaw Tom would come up to and wait as the vehicles come down this long hill. Now, this steep incline would force the wagon trains to slow down to almost a crawl to be able to make the corner to the bridge. And as soon as they did, Hacksaw would jump out with his sawed-off double-barrel shotgun, and that's the reason they called him Hacksaw, and he would relieve all those passengers of their goods. And then he would scamper back up the trails and nobody would be able to get him. The greatest thing about Hacksaw Tom was that he never fired a shot. For all the times and all the wagons and all the automobiles that he held up, he never once fired a shot, right? He never once fired his gun. He became such a legend that even the wagon masters would bring their friends along so they could say that they got held up by Hacksaw Tom. Isn't that incredible? And he scampered up there. Now, years later, somebody was looking in these very caves, and what they found was Hacksaw Tom, who wore a bag over his head with two slits and that sawed-off shotgun. They found that. They found his gun. They found the bag. They found beans. They found supplies to show that he'd been in this very cave. Isn't that absolutely incredible? That's just another one of the legends and the curses of the Superstition Mountains. Now, they say Tom's whole thought process was he was a miner that didn't hit the mother load, so he decided that he was going to mine the passengers' pocketbooks. They also say that he cursed any of the modern technologies. And when those cars came in, he knew it was his time, that, you know what? It was only a matter of time. If he didn't stop this thieving ways, and you know, he was going to end up caught eventually. But they never caught Hacksaw Tom, ever. Jay Shrek, Myths, Lies, and Legends. Not necessarily in that order either.
When construction of Roosevelt Dam began, a wagon road was built to haul supplies to the site. At the base of Fish Creek Hill, a bandit began holding up the wagons as they crossed the old bridge. He never shot anyone, and never even fired his weapon. In fact, it became such a routine that the wagon drivers would take along friends just so they could say they'd been held up. In 1968, a pair of brothers were prospecting along the Salt River, and in a tributary canyon, found a cave with a military wagon in it. They left it be, and many years later overheard a story about a sub-chief named Nana, who had held up a military payroll and hid it in a cave with a wagon. After three attempts, they finally found the cave and parts of the wagon. They dug under it and found a satchel with all these items in it. Hacksaw Tom was never caught, so why did they name him Hacksaw? Take a close look at that shotgun.
This area is absolutely breathtaking. And you know, one thing when we're up here, a lot of people have decided that Superstition Mountains is going to be their last resting ground, right? And what we're finding is more and more and more memorials to people that, you know, they must have been in love with this place. It is a fascinating, beautiful place as we look up on these walls where the fires have been burnt. You know, Indians came through here thousands and thousands, thousands of years ago, right? 1,300 years. And they were in these very caves.